Nice to see you all again. I'm here with Dr. Derrick Alridge, who is a two-time graduate of Winthrop University. Thank you for joining us. You spoke today at the Interprayer dinner or breakfast. So tell me a little bit about what it was like being back here in Rock Hill.
Oh, it was a pleasure to be back in Rock Hill, to see some of my old friends, to see my family members, and to be back in this space because it means so much to me. You know, Rock Hill was special to me for many reasons. It was where I grew up, where I came of age, and it was where I went to high school, but also to college. So just seeing old friends and family really was great.
Now, you mentioned that your church family was here. You went to Liberty Baptist Church?
I went to Liberty Hill Baptist Church in Catawba, South Carolina, which is about a 20-minute drive from Rock Hill.
Okay. Now, you touched on some pretty hot topics right now. You spoke about immigration and inclusion, and the president recently made some comments. What are your views on those comments?
Well, I feel that those comments were unfortunate for many reasons. Dr. King not only talked about the beloved community, but he talked about the concept of a world house, which I didn't mention in my lecture this morning. And the world house was the idea that all of us live on this planet together and that we will have to make a decision. And that decision would be to all live together as brothers and sisters or perish together as fools. And we have the kind of rhetoric that identifies certain groups of people from certain countries as not being worthy of coming to the United States. I think we're going against the very idea of what it means to be the United States. And so I think Dr. King would be very saddened to have heard the president's comments.
Now, you also mentioned that in Dr. King's last book that he published, he asked the question, where do we go from here, chaos or community? So in your opinion, what's the answer?
Well, certainly I believe we should go towards community, and we are not there yet. Dr. King, by 1967, when he wrote the book, Where Do We Go, Chaos or Community, he had become somewhat saddened by the fact that racism seemed to have become more entrenched in 1967. And he believed then that we had a long way to go, but he always had hope. So we're not there yet, but I think we're moving in the right direction. And being back in Rock Hill, I certainly feel like Rock Hill is moving in the right direction.
Now, you grew up here, you're from here, so what have you seen change since you were a little boy?
Well, one thing, I see that there were two new African American women on the city council, is that correct? And I see that Winthrop is thriving, a number of African American students are at Winthrop, and I see a lot of real estate and construction going on. So the city is becoming kind of a world-class city, especially when you consider with the new, what is it called, where you can ride the bicycles?
The BMX
track. Yeah, you know, that's just a sign that Rock Hill is really becoming a world-class city. So I'm very optimistic and very happy with the direction of the city.
Now, you mentioned some pretty prominent figures in the audience today, like Dr. Cynthia Roddy. What role did those figures play in your upbringing?
Well, Dr. Cynthia Roddy went to my church. I grew up in a church with her, and her two sons and her daughter were very good friends of mine. So I grew up in a church with someone who was already a well-known civil rights activist. And so she really inspired me. And I had the opportunity to interview a number of teachers in the community who I didn't even know had participated in the civil rights movement, like Ann Reed and others. And I think we can also say someone like Edward Newton, who lived in my neighborhood, and Mr. and Mrs. Smalls, who also lived in Laney Terrace. All of those are heroes, as well as Barbara Bowell. So I grew up around a number of educators who were also activists during the civil rights movement, and they inspired me growing up.
Well, thank you so much for this, your time. This has been a learning experience for me. I do appreciate you all watching, and we'll be right back after this.
Carolina Connection is brought to you by Founders Federal Credit Union. For more information, visit foundersfcu.com. Relax, you're with Founders.